So I belong to a lower middle class family, been brought up in a house which is just one room. So today, I stayed in a house which is as big as a bathroom I used today. And there is a concept called as chawl in India, where we go to public toilets. So we carry our buckets and we go to a public toilet. I studied in a very small school, and it was called as an English medium school, but we hardly spoke in English. So we hardly spoke in English. And my parents both were working. They were central government employees. They really worked hard to bring me up. And because they couldn't manage much from whatever they used to earn, I have seen my parents doing part-time business. And the part-time business used to be selling saris in local trains. So they have done a lot. I'm sorry. So I come from that background and managed to obviously study, and they did a lot for me to study, and they ensured that I get some good job. And then my journey started to earn money. I worked for close to 15 years. Started as a telecaller. Today, a lot of people get irritated with telecalls that you get. You say credit cards, people call and bug you. Thank you. So I was one of them. But I was very happy that from day one I started off, I gave my 100% in anything and everything that I did. And did good for myself. And I grew from a telecaller to becoming something that most of the corporate guys aspire to be. I became a CEO of a company. But my hunger was there. I didn't know what was the hunger for. I had no clue what the hunger was for. Life was on. And while this was going on, I had a few personal challenges on relationships. I had a broken relationship. And my father always said that he never wanted a daughter. And he had his own reasons of why not a daughter, because he had three sisters and he had gone through a lot to get them married. And when I was born, he was very happy. I mean, I have the best dad anyone could ever have in this world. But obviously, I knew the reason why he didn't want a daughter. And when I went through a broken relationship, he cried and he said, "This is why I didn't want to have a daughter. That I can't take the pain. I didn't want to take this pain." He's already seen his sister going through something. And when I saw my dad saying that, is when I got angry. And I took a decision. And I think that decision has got me here. From the day I took the decision, I think I was figuring out how do I do something in life that I have my own. I see success. But I said that I was angry and I was hungry. I'll tell you what I was angry about. I was angry about the way things were around me. Okay? So how many of them are angry? Okay. So I'll tell you what I did. When I was angry, I didn't crip cry. I changed things. I just changed. So every time I was angry, I've taken a decision that I don't want to see this again in my life. Never again. So there are a couple of things where, things that happened in my life where I have taken a decision when I got angry. So that was once that I really got angry and I said I need to do something where I never ever face anything like this again. That people take me for granted, I lose things and I keep crying. So I started looking out, I was in a seeking mode and this business came into my life. It came into my life, I started off, I think that was similar, a year and a half, a huge team, but one side. The other side, every person I signed up was sleeping. Every person I signed up was sleeping. And I didn't know what was happening. But trust me, I was so busy that I didn't have time to even think why things are like that. I didn't have time to think. So I kept on and on. So my first week on. So a lot of people are, you know, I'm in servers there and I keep looking at people. People are crying about not having place and they're getting pissed off and moving out. I'll tell you what, I didn't have money when I came for my first week on. You know, I was so excited when I started off the business. In first month, I made so much money that I quit my job. Okay? I quit my job. I went full time. Okay? It was a it was just the decision. I said, let me just go full time. I went full time. And then for a year and a half, no money. No money to come for VCON. So let me tell you, people say that I don't have money. I don't have jewelry to sell. I don't have funds to sell. I don't have a car to sell. I had nothing to sell. I sold off. Guess what did I sell to travel? Newspaper. Okay? Every rupee was important for me. So all the newspapers at home, I started counting even that. How much money will I get if I sell newspaper? How much money will I get if I sell my music system? How much money will I get if I sell my table? How much money will I get if I sell my TV? So I have sold things to survive. Okay? And then I don't have money. I still didn't have money. I had to come for VCON. Guess what? So most of them are embarrassed, they cry, they crib about not having money to come to VCON. I borrowed money from my maid. Because my maid had two daughters. Let me finish. My maid had two daughters who were also working. She was earning more than me. I borrowed money from my maid. And I didn't have money to even pay her. For 3 months she worked without salary and she said, I'm not going to leave you. And she was giving me money. I had no money for grocery. She used to cook food in her house and she used to get it for me. Okay? But at that time, most of them, if go through something like this, they feel sad and bad and low. You know what I told my maid? I said, just give me some time. Okay? You there for me, I'll be there for you all your life. And both her daughters, one daughter quit the maid's job today. She's a topper in the school. Okay? The second daughter has got married. I've got her married and she's got a daughter and she's happy with her family. So most of them think that how can I borrow money? I didn't feel ashamed. I knew that she had something which I didn't have at that time. But what I could do, she can never do. So I knew I was going to do something for her as well. I knew what I was doing. So I was confident that I'm going to do it. It was not about company project. It was about me being confident. I was sure. And that's how I started off, a year and a half, and then the other side started off, and then no looking back. Oh, it doesn't stop there. Everything was going on fine, huge team, edified, blah, 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 all happening. And suddenly something shakes. Newspapers and everybody in the organization started looking at things in a very different way. I don't know what happened. People showed belief, conviction, blah, blah, all that. But one small challenge, I think it's a small challenge. One small challenge, everybody got shaken. Now, then I realized, that is when I realized what dream is. Because I didn't get shaken. I didn't get shaken at all. That's when I realized, now I know what dream means. Though I used to take modules and sessions with my team talking about dream, I knew so many people talking about it in my organization. That's when I realized, I have not got shaken. So all the modules that I had attended of all big speakers, you know, it made sense. Oh, this is what happens. Decision, dream, this is what it means. Not moving, just not moving. You getting me? So that's exactly what happened. So 6 months back, things changed. Business, very different scene. From somewhere I reached, it came down. Because I had built it, I knew how to build it again. And I made another decision. I was angry again. I made another decision. And I said, India team is going to rock in this VCON. It's going to fucking rock in this VCON. That's all I decided. We're going to scream so loud. It's going to shake. So there's only one thing I want to say. I want to end with one thing. One thing. There's one Hindi poetry I want to say. Okay? Zindagi to apne kandhon pe chalti hai yaro. Zindagi to apne kandhon pe chalti hai yaro. Auron ke kandhon pe to janaze uthte hain. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Good.